Good morning and welcome to Cottage Montessori online with me, Karen.
And me, Monique. Hi.
Hello, everybody. We're going to sing a hello song, and it's our bread and butter marmalade and jam hello song. So we usually keep time either on the table or on your lap, on your knees, your thighs. It goes like this. Bread and butter, marmalade and jam. And we're all going to say it together. When I say, you know, when I say, let's say hello as fast as we can, we're going to say all together, very fast, or very slow, or very loud, or very quiet. We're going to do it all different ways. Bread and butter, marmalade and jam. Let's say hello as slow as we can. Okay, let's do it together. Bread and butter, marmalade and jam. Let's say hello as fast as we can. You ready? Hello. Bread and butter, marmalade and jam. Let's say hello as quiet as we can. Bread and butter, marmalade and jam. Let's say hello as loud as we can. Hello! It probably wasn't really as loud as I can say it, but I didn't want to hurt my own ears. I mean, I could do it as loud as I want outside, but in here that was good and loud. Bread and butter, marmalade and jam. Let's say hello in the highest voice we can. Bread and butter, marmalade and jam. Let's say hello in the lowest voice we can. Last one. Bread and butter, marmalade and jam. Let's say hello just as nicely as we can. Hello.
Hello.
Nice to see you. Well, Monique, it is your turn.
It is so great to see everybody. I hope you've been having some fun outside and getting to watch things grow. Things are going to really start ramping up with the growing now because we're getting closer. The spring is really moving ahead and we've had a number of sunny days here. So things are really going to grow faster. And you know, we've been growing some things at our houses too, inside. And I just wanted to give you an update on my celery situation, because the celery, you might remember, we cut off the top of the celery and just a little tiny celery leaves were growing. You can kind of see that. It was very sweet, but you can also see, the celery itself is getting pretty gross and sort of slimy. And I think it's kind of rotting. It's too bad because there was a tiny little, I don't want to drip water on my computer, so I won't get any closer, a tiny other little bud starting in the middle of the celery, but I just don't think it's going to ever grow to be celery that we could eat. So I think we will say goodbye to the celery. I'm going to put it in the compost, and then the worms can eat it and turn it into dirt, and then maybe it'll get used to grow other celery in the ground. I think celery grows better in the ground than in water. It was pretty interesting to see how much would grow just using water.
I mean, before we can really plant our gardens, it's so fun to see things sprouting inside.
Yeah.
A lot. Wow, thank you. Well, I have an activity to show you today that I'm pretty excited about. I saw this in a video online and I had to watch it several times because I was like, how does that work? And this is a flashlight underwater, flashlight under the sea craft that we're going to make. Reach it way over here. And it goes like this. It looks like this. What is there under the sea? I'm going to see what's in there. I put my flashlight in there so I can, my under the sea is closed up. Here we go. I put this flashlight in there so I can see all the things under the ocean. Oh my goodness, look at that. So many things under the ocean. It's a good thing I have a flashlight. It's dark under there.
It looks like there's nothing in there. And then cool. A flashlight.
So I'm going to show you how to make one of these, because it's I just think it's so much fun. And the first thing you're going to need is a piece of white construction paper and a piece of black construction paper. And you're also going to need either a baggie, like I have this very big, one of these sizes of baggies. I suppose, you know, I was thinking if you don't have baggies at home, maybe you have a sheet protector or your mom or dad does. Now the sheet protector, you'd have to put your flashlight in, make this the bottom and put your flashlight in this way. But with a baggie, you can hold it this way. Now, I'm gonna turn this down so you can tilt this down so you can see. So the first thing that I wanna do is make my paper be able to fit in my baggie. So I'm taking them both together and I'm putting it, leaving a little tiny bit on the outside edge so I can see it. And then over here, there's that edge. I'm gonna take a ruler and mark it so it's just on the inside edge of the paper. I'm gonna get my pencil and here, I wanna make sure it's gonna fit in there. Right. And then I can cut, you know what I'm doing? I'm cutting both pieces together. I'm just keeping them together. And I just made one line, but I can cut both pieces because the black is under the white.
That's nice, because it would be hard to make a line on the black that you could see.
It's hard to see it, right? So then I'm gonna slip this into my baggie. But I'm gonna show you on one that I've already done, already slipped it in here.
The screen has moved. Yeah, thank you.
And so there it is. It's inside. And you will notice that there's, you know, this is a Ziploc bag and they want to show you, you know, whose bag it is in case you want to buy them again. I just put that on the back so I can't see it. So I've got my white so I can see what I'm doing. Now, this is the fun part, and this is the, well, this is one of the fun parts, and this is something you could take a long time doing. What I did with my C is the first thing I did was I drew, kind of thought, what's the bottom of the ocean? The bottom of the ocean is sand, so I'm going to draw kind of a line. That's the bottom of the ocean where the sand is. And then I just kind of filled it in first. And then I filled in the top too. And on mine, I kind of smeared it around so it would be a little smoother, but you can do it however you want to. And then to make the sea, make sure that, see, I'm doing this. Now on the plastic, you'll notice on mine, it's being a little bit watery, actually. It's kind of beading up, but that's good because then I can kind of smear it around like this. So you see how that makes it?
Kind of spreading it to fill in all the areas.
Yeah, and it makes this part look more like the water on top of the sand. Yeah. And you could even just have this part be blue because that's just the water, but I made it a little bit like that. My finger's getting a little markery, but that's okay. These are washable markers. It'll come off. And then I think I did a darker one down here because that's a little darker because the land or the sand is under there. And then after you get that on, then I'm going to be trying to do this upside down because it's facing you. But then you can make all kinds of fish. Sometimes I do like a little couple bubbles coming out from the fish. You can make, I'm going to make a red jellyfish. Jellyfish is actually pretty easy. You just kind of make like a almost an egg shape, just the top of it though. And then that's the top of a jellyfish body. And then they just have wavy legs coming out of the bottom. That's a jellyfish. You can make, let me do is another color. You can make a starfish or anything you want. The other thing I used green for is plants like seaweed. So you can see you can do a lot with that. Now, You need a flashlight. So you could spend a long time decorating your sea. That could take a whole afternoon if you wanted to, just decorating your sea and your sea creatures. Now we need a flashlight, right? You could make yours just on white construction paper. I happen to have some cardstock, which is a little thicker than construction paper. But even with that, I noticed my flashlight is a little wiggly. So I was thinking that maybe in the future, I would trace on some cardboard on the same shape and cut it out and glue it on so that it wasn't quite so wiggly. So here's how I did that. I started with this oval shape or ellipse shape. It's actually more of an ellipse because it's the same on both sides. And then I made that my glowing flashlight. I filled that in. And then I decided, you know what, maybe I'll do a different color this time. All right. So then you could take a color like this. And you can make some lines down from that. Yeah, I'll make it your way so you can see what I'm doing a little bit better. And that's going to be the part right under the light. And you know what? I do want to do it with a pencil though, in case I make a mistake, then I can erase it. And then I made the bottom of my flashlight. It's a flashlight is round. You hold it in your hand like that, and this is how I make it look round. I make round edges. I'm gonna bring it all the way up. All the way up. I need a button to turn it on and off, right? Or at least to pretend to turn it on and off. And another line, and another line. And let's see. I just feel like doing a purple. You can make this, of course, any color you want because it's your flashlight. All right. And yeah, then I could color that in. What I did with this one, and I often like to do this, is make the outline with marker and then do the inside with colored pencil. Whoops, my point just came off. But you know what, you can just color over marker with colored pencil and the lines from the marker still show. So you kind of know what I mean by that. So you could just go over, I'm gonna make this one purpley. Do. There's the thing. So you can, you know, make it, you can be creative. You can make this however you want. But the important thing after I decorate my flashlight is I need the beam of light coming out of my flashlight. And so for that, I'm just going to make two lines coming out. And even if I don't make my lines very straight, what's good about this is that my scissors will make a straight line. So I will just point my scissors toward the flashlight. And I will get a line. And I'm cutting along the outside edge so I can get my whole flashlight here. And again.
And I noticed, Karen, that you're moving the paper.
I am. Because it'd be so uncomfortable to be cutting like this, right?
Right.
So, that is what I do. I move the paper. I turn the paper so I can keep just cutting like this in front of me. That's a good point. All right. And then straight edge is going to go all the way in. And there's my new flashlight. Ah. I have two flashlights. I can see all over the place. All right. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I want to show you. I'm gonna put this is the one I made that I worked on for a long time yesterday, and it's the one that I first showed you. And you can see it looks almost magical. It looks like you're really putting a flashlight under the ocean, but I want to show you how it's really done. Come on, baggy. This is a tight fit. Like I must have made that exactly the right width. Yeah. Ha, ha.
Things are starting to appear.
Well, look, that's what was really, it's because the drawing is on the plastic, isn't it? It's not really on the black oceany part and the dark deep depths of the ocean. And something I was thinking of that I'm noticing that these are a little light. After you make your creatures, if you want to, if it's okay with your mom and dad, you could take Sharpie markers, colorful Sharpie markers if you have them. And either you could or you could have your mom and dad go along the edges, because it will show up a little better probably with Sharpie marker.
And everybody remembers, right, that Sharpie marker is permanent. So if you're using it and it touches your hand or touches your furniture or your clothes, it'll stay there.
And yeah, it won't wash off. And it won't wash off your fingers right away either. Whereas this, so that's why I say either, you know, with parental supervision, that means your mom or dad watching you, or else you could say, hey, mom, can you, or dad, can you do the outside edges of my creatures? And then they might show up a little bit. See how that's a little deeper color?
Oh boy, can't wait to see what the...
So I just did a bunch of, I did fish, I did little shells, I did a crab. I actually found that picture online and I tried to copy it. So that's what I did. And then after you're done drawing, and you know, like I said, you might take a whole afternoon, then you just pull that white piece of paper out. And let's see, let's see if my new flashlight works just as well as my old flashlight. Let's go into the sea and see what's in there. Pick this up a little bit. Oh my goodness, look, there's a fish. There's a jellyfish. Oh, there's a little angel fish and a crab.
So that is so cool.
Underwater flashlight. Have fun.
Like with magic.
That. Yeah. Oh, one thing I wanted to tell you about. These markers, the markers that kids usually use, the washable markers, especially on plastic, can rub off. So, you know, be careful when you're drawing it. You know, you'll have the white underneath so you can see what you're doing. But you want to be careful that you don't rub on it, or even by accident, even the next day, because the plastic doesn't hold it as well as the paper. You know, you can make a marker drawing and then rub on the paper the next day and it's just in there. Not necessarily on the plastic, so be careful with that. So you, after you do all your hard work, you don't want it to rub away, right? Let's have a little bit of circle time. First thing I need for circle time is a tissue. You don't need it, but my nose is a little runny. So I'm gonna do this first. Okay. I'm a little teapot, short and stout. Here is my handle, here is my spout. When I get all steamed up, hear me shout. Tip me over and pour me out. Here we go. Get down here a little bit, get closer to you. Oats, peas, beans, and barley grow. Oats, peas, beans, and barley grow. Neither you nor I nor anyone knows how oats, peas, beans, and barley grow. Another type of garden song. And then there's the counting with potatoes. You ready? Here's your potato. Here's your other potato. One potato, two potato, three potato, four, five potato, six potato, seven potato more. I like that because it's like, you can keep going up and up, but it kind of stays right in front of you. Or you could make them go. You could keep stacking them up. Or you can more and more and more like that. It kind of reminds me of the rock, paper, scissors game that we played before. Like that. Let's see if I can remember the Six Little Ducks song. Six little ducks that I once knew. Fat ones, skinny ones. The other kind. Fair ones too. But the ones duck with the feather on his back. He led the others with a quack, 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 quack. He led the others with a quack, quack, quack. Down to the river they would go. Wibble, wobble, wibble, wobble, ho, ho, ho. But the one little duck with the feather on his back, he led the others with a quack, 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 quack. He led the others with a quack, quack, quack. Down back from the river they would come, wibble, wobble, wibble, wobble, ho, ho, hum. But the one little duck with the feather on his back, he led the others with a quack, 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 quack. He led the others with a quack, quack, quack. It's the duck song. All right, let's do a little bit of a dance party with the Counting Stars song. It's one of my favorites because it starts out slow and then it starts out slow and soft and then it gets a little louder. And you know what? I need to share my screen. And I need to go to the computer sound and then share it. Here we go.
I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. But baby, I've been praying hard. Said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars. Yeah, we'll be counting stars. Like a swinging vine, swing my heart across the line. In my face is flashing signs. Seek it out and ye shall find. Old, but I'm not that old. Young, but I'm not that bold. And I don't think the world is sold. I'm just doing what we're told. Kills me, makes me feel alive.
This is the point of the class where I really need my three quiet breaths. Let's try to do that together. One. It's my under the sea finger. That's okay. One. Very good. All right. And I just realized that I forgot to cue something up here, which is our storybook. And it should be right in here. Oh, there we go. Okay. I have so many folders on my desk. It's just a little crazy. I'm looking for this week's classes. I think I found it. There it is. All right. There it is. It doesn't want to go. Yes, it does. Okay. Well, this is a story that you're going to be very well familiar with, I know. And we're still doing a few Mother's Day songs, stories. So I found this on YouTube and I wanted to be able to show you, and we'll see if it comes up now, because right now it's doing this. Have you ever tried to look up something on your computer and it goes like this? That's what it's doing. All right, I think we're ready. And first, what I need to do is, there we go. Okay, I'm going to share my screen with you. And hopefully it will start soon.
Is your mama a llama?
That's the story. Is your mama a llama? We're going to start it in just a second. I have to go back. I am sorry for the delay here, friends. I thought I was all set to go. All right, here we go. Make this bigger. I'm going to, Wow, I am so sorry. This is not coming out the way I wanted to. Okay, anyway, I think I'm ready now. Share my screen with you. And, I don't know why I'm not seeing it, but I'm gonna say that's my desktop. That's why I'm not seeing it. Because now, okay, where did it go? Where did it go? Have you noticed that I am not really experienced on there we go. Okay, so it's Thursday, and we're going to go down to this guy, which was on here before and now is not. No. There we go. That's disappeared. I'm wondering if we're going to be able to watch this. Here we go. Okay, so now. All right. There we go.
Okay.
So is your mama a llama? Someone else is showing it, and I'm reading it. I bet you know this story. Is your mama a llama? I asked my friend Dave. No, she is not, is the answer Dave gave. What kind of animal is Dave? She hangs by her feet and she lives in a cave. I do not believe that's how llamas behave. Oh, I said, you are right about that. I think that your mama sounds more like bat. Is your mama a llama? I asked my friend Fred. No, she is not, is what Freddy said. She has a long neck and white feathers and wings. I don't think a llama has all of those things. Oh, I said, you don't need to go on. I think that your mama must be a, what do you think? Swan. Is your mama a llama? I asked my friend Jane. No, she is not, Jane politely explained. She grazes on grass and she likes to say moo. I don't think that's what a llama would do. Oh, I said, I understand now. I think that your mama must be a, can you guess? Cow. Is your mama a llama? I asked my friend Clyde. No, she is not, is how Clyde replied. She's got flippers and whiskers and eats fish all day. I do not think llamas act quite in that way. Oh, I said, I'm beginning to feel that your mama must really be a, what do you think? Seal. Is your mama a llama? I asked my friend Rhonda. No, she is not, is how Rhonda responded. She's got big hind legs and a pocket for me. So I don't think a llama is what she could be. Oh, I said, that is certainly true. I think that your mama's a kangaroo. Is your mama a llama? I asked my friend Lynn. Oh, Lloyd, don't be silly, Lynn said with a grin. My mama has big ears, long lashes, and fur, and you of all people should know about her. Our mamas belong to the same herd, and you know all about llamas, because you are one too. Yes, you are right, I said to my friend. My mama's a llama. And this is the end. Aw, they're all cozied up there together. That's very sweet. Okay, then we've got kind of a commercial there. I'm going to stop sharing as we don't need to know what they're trying to sell us. All right. There we go. Can you hear me, Monique?
Yep.
Oh, okay, good. Looked like I was still muted, but now I'm not. Well, that was an adventure in book reading, but it's a great story. I love Is Your Mama a Llama? It's one of my favorites. Well, thanks for bearing with us during technical difficulties, and I'm glad you could join us today. And we'll see you next time.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.